In this video, I will be introducing the idea of what a relation and a function is. Both of these could be represented in different ways. For instance, we could have a table of values, a graph, a formula. This is the most common way you'll see it. Words, where it's described, a set of ordered pairs, and a picture. So let's see what I mean by that. All right, so a relation is a pairing of two things. There is an input and out comes an output. And so one way you might do it, let's say I've got this picture and I've got some numbers to make it easy, the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then I have this output, and let's say over here I have a 3, 4, and a 5. So what I could do is draw a picture to say what happens each input might have, more than one output or just one output. So here's an example of a picture of a relation. Now, what it's saying is the input is over here on the left and the output is over here on the right. Now, if I was going to write that as a set of ordered pairs, notice I have, if I put in a 1, I get a 3. Also, if I put in a 1, I get a 4, right? Okay, so those take care of those two lines. And then I've got 2 also going to 4. So here's another ordered pair, 2, 4. I have this other ordered pair, 3, 5. And say I have an ordered pair, 4, 5. So notice I have four lines here, so there should be four ordered pairs, and this is another way of showing this relation. And we could write that as a set, so we could use braces. We could also do that in a little table. Remember I said you could do it in a little table? And we could say, well, let's say the input we'll call like x if we want, and the output we can call y. You could write the word input and output. So if the input is 1, the output was 3. Also, when I had an input of 1, I was able to get an output of 4. When I input a 2, I was able to get an output of 4. When I input a 3, I got an output of 5. And when I input 4, I also got an output of 5. And then I said you could describe this in words. You would say 1 goes to 3. You could just say that in words. 1 goes to 3, 1 also goes to 4, 2 goes to 4, 3 goes to 5, and 4 goes to 5. I'm not going to write that all out, but that's how you could describe it in words. This one doesn't have a particular formula, but we'll be getting into some of them where we could also write this as a formula. And let's see, the other one we did was a graph. So let's say we just did a little graph. Usually what we do is we make the input x and the output y, and for my inputs I've got the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4, and for my output I have 3, 4, and 5. So let's see. I'm going to make the lengths on the y-axis different than that of the x-axis, but here's 5 and here's 5. So if I wanted to draw what those ordered pairs are, here's 1, 3. And I also have 1, 5, I mean, I'm sorry, 1, 4. I've got 2, 4. And I have 3, 5. And I have 4, 5. So there's like four ways that I could show this particular relation. We call all of the inputs the domain, and we call all of the outputs the range. So let's see, from this particular picture, if I was going to list what was called the domain, that's the set of inputs, okay? Well, what numbers do I have? I have 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's my domain. Notice I don't write 1 twice, because it's just a set of numbers and there's only four numbers. It's just that one is listed more than once. And then for my range, That's the set of outputs. What do I have? All I have is a 3, 4, and 5. It's easy to see in the picture, right? I've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 for my inputs. My outputs are 3, 4, and 5. Right, so it's a lot of vocabulary just to get started, but basically the idea is this relation has some inputs and some outputs. You might have noticed that if the relation is written as a set of ordered pairs, or if you're looking at the graph of the relation, the domain is simply the set of x values and the range is the set of y values. But you might not be looking at a relation that is written with numbers in it at all. So let's look at a different kind of relation. How about this relation? Here's a relation that shows the husband's names of four sisters, Amy, Beth, Cindy, and Denise. All right, to make it simple, let's see if I just draw a picture, and I'll use the first letter of their name so I don't have to write it out. And I'm going to write over here who they married. All right, so actually, Amy and Beth both married John. Then I would draw a picture to say both of them married someone named John. And let's say that Cindy married Mark. So I would draw a picture, arrow, Cindy married Mark. And let's say Denise married Steve, and that's his first name. So if we're just doing the first names, that's, for instance, a picture of what that relation would look like. Now you could also write them as ordered pairs, Amy, John, Beth, John, Cindy, Mark, and Denise, Steve. You could write them as an ordered pairs, it's just that they don't have any numbers in them. You should be able to figure out what the domain and range is. The domain would be Amy, Beth, Cindy, and Denise, right? That's the input. And the range would be just John, Mark, and Steve. I could write those out, but hopefully you're getting the idea. Here's a picture of a relation, and the relation is the ordered pairs that you see. So see if you can state the relation as a set of ordered pairs, and then state the domain and state the range. And you want to use set notation, so use braces. So put the video on pause and try that. All right, so let's do it. We're going to state the relation as a set of ordered pairs. I've got 5 ordered pairs, so I'm just going to list all the ordered pairs. And it doesn't matter the order you write the ordered pairs in. So I notice I have this one ordered pair right here. That's 1, 1. And I also have one up here. That's 1, 4. Got this one right here. That's over 2 and up 1. Got the 1 right on the x-axis here. This is the x and y-axis, right? That's 3, 0. And I have one over here, 4, negative 1. So that's a different way of writing the relation. If I want to state the domain, it's the set of x values or the inputs or the x values here. So I've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. And for the range, what do I have? I have a 1, a 4, I've got 1 again, 0, and negative 1. And it doesn't matter the order you put them in, I'm going to put them from lowest to smallest. I've got negative 1, 0, 1, and 4. You're basically looking at the y values over here. So you can see the where's the y value here, 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 here. You see that's down at negative 1, 0, 1, and 5 if you're checking out the y values. All right, we're going to get to just the very basic idea of a function. In a function, each input always has exactly one output. You can think of there being like a little function machine here. It's called a function machine. So if I put something in, if I put my input in there, it's like it does some stuff in here. Okay, there's something going on in here. And then out pops an output. An exactly one output comes out of there. It's not like the next time I put in the exact same thing, something different will come out. So in the next video, we're going to concentrate on functions.